Namaste to all. Welcome to the YouTube channel of Arasu Group of School. In this session, we will continue with the topic that is carbonates and its compounds, chapter number 4, class 10, science. And this is the part 10th of this chapter. In this chapter, in this particular video, we will see some important carbon compounds. Some important carbon compound means the compounds which are commercially and industrially very useful to us. So let's see, we will see two carbon compounds which are very important industrially and commercially. First we will see the ethanoic acid, we will see its physical properties and chemical properties. Then we will see the ethanol, then we will see its physical and chemical properties. So ethanoic acid, so as its name depicts, we have already discussed the naming, IUPAC naming of the carbon compounds. Ethanoic acid, as its name depicts, it contains the functional group, that is carboxylic acid. जब carboxylic acid होता है तो attachment क्या आती है? Attachment is COOH, that can also be written as C double bond O and OH. So what is the general basic molecular formula of this ethanoic acid? Its molecular formula is CH3 C double bond OH. See how many carbons are there? 2, that's why ethanoic. Ethane and oic acid represent this particular functional group. Generally, commonly, we also name this ethanoic acid as acetic acid. Bhi inko kaha jata hai generally. So let's see some physical properties. 5 to 8% solution of this acetic acid in water is known as vinegar. 5 to 8% हमें ये लेना है ethanoic acid और उसको water में mix करना है. The solution is known as vinegar and you all know vinegar is used in the kitchen, in our houses also. It is used to preserve, as a preservative in the pickles, jams, etc. It is a weak acid. Ethanoic acid is a weak acid. We have also studied the strong acid and weak acid. Strong acid, those who can ionize completely into their solution are known as strong acid. Since this carboxylic acid, that is ethanoic acid, cannot dissociate completely into its solution, that's why it is known as a weak acid. It cannot ionize completely into its solution. Next physical property you will see is the melting point. Especially, it is very important. Melting point of ethanoic acid is very less. It is 290 Kelvin. It is 290 Kelvin. The melting point of ethanol is 290 Kelvin. That is approximately 17 degrees Celsius. That means it, in the winter climate, in the cold climate, in the winter, when the temperature goes below 17 degrees Celsius, it becomes solid and converts into the solid crystal-like structures. That's why resembling the glaciers of the poles, that's why it is also known as glacial acetic acid. So you must have to know, you must have acknowledged this point, why this acetic acid is known as glacial acetic acid. Because its melting point is very less and it freezes at 17 degrees Celsius only in the winter climate. Okay, so these are the basic physical properties of ethanoic acid. Let's see some chemical properties. As you have already studied, chemical properties means the chemical reaction. What are the basic chemical reactions of this ethanoic acid? How does it react with the various compounds? First and very important reaction that is given by ethanoic acid is the reaction with ethanol. Whenever this ethanoic acid, that is the formula CH3COOH, ethanoic acid reacted with ethanol, having formula ethanol, what is it? Is an alcohol. It is alcohol having two carbon atoms in it. The two carbon atom ethanol, when it is reacted with ethanol and it is mild heating, we will heat them. What you have to do? You have to take 1 ml or 2 ml, just you can do it. What you have to do? You just have to take both the compounds, that is ethanoic acid and ethanol, both add them and heat them, and during heating add some concentrated sulfuric acid to it. What will form as a result? The compound formed as a result is known as ester, and water is released in this formation. It is very important reaction. Try to understand it very, very firmly. All of you see, generally acid release hydrogen ion when they are dissolved in the water. But in this particular case, we have seen that it is acid. हम generally देखेंगे तो ऐसा लगेगा कि ये भी यहाँ पर hydrogen release करेगा. But यहाँ पर ये hydrogen release नहीं करता है. यहाँ पर इस particular case में ये जो ethanoic acid है अपने OH ions को यहाँ पर release करेगा. और जो hydrogen है, hydrogen will come from the ethanol. So OH from ethanoic acid, hydrogen from ethanol. When these both combined will result in the formation of water. और जो जितना बचा हुआ compound है, मतलब ये सारा compound except hydrogen and this complete compound except OH, इन दोनों को जब combine करके लिखेंगे, we will write it like this. And this compound is known as ester. Because this is the formation. Why the special name ester is given? Because it is a sweet smelling compound. It is a sweet smelling compound. Industrially, it is very useful. It is used as the flavoring agents. It is also used as a flavoring agent. Sweet smelling hai, achhi smell aa rahi hai iski. That's why it is also used as a flavoring agents in the perfumes. Some perfumes mein bhi is ester ka use karte hain. Because in this reaction ester is forming, that's why this particular reaction of ethanoic acid with ethanol, this particular reaction is known as esterification. Also known as esterification reaction. Use this very, very important reaction, students. So keep it in mind. Okay. Now, when this ester is reacted with the alkali. Alkali means it is reacted with a base such as sodium hydroxide. It result in the formation of, again, it result back in the formation of ethanol. See, ethanol is formed again. क्या हो रहा है basically? हम इस ester को जब दोबारा base से react करवा रहे हैं, alkali से react करवा रहे हैं, दोबारा जिससे ये बना था ethanol, back ethanol बन जाता है, plus ethanol के साथ में this compound is formed. This compound is known as this compound. This compound is known as sodium acetate. Sodium acetate, or it is also known as sodium ethanoid. Sodium ethanoid भी इसको बोल सकते हैं और sodium acetate भी बोल सकते हैं. दोनों ही name इस compound के लिए एकदम सही है. Sodium acetate और sodium ethanoid. One more important thing, students. ये जो compound बना है, this compound is forms the basic formula of soap. ये जो compound है, ये soap का, this compound is a basic formula of soap. जो soaps होती हैं, they are the long chain. उनके अंदर बस यहाँ पर एक carbon के जगह कई सारे carbon जो है एक long chain में जुड़े हुए होंगे. इस carbon के अंदर यहाँ पे दो ही carbon हैं. In the place of two carbons, if many carbons are joined together in a chain, then it will form a soap. So basically, it is the general formula of soap. Since in this reaction, I am talking about this particular reaction. This reaction I am talking about. In this reaction, this formula is forming, that is the formula of soap. That's why this particular reaction is also known as saponification reaction. This reaction is also known as saponification reaction. Okay. Next reaction we will see. Next we will see the reaction of ethanoic acid with base. So we have already studied the reaction of acid with base. When acid reacts with base, it result in the formation of salt and water. Similarly, these ethanoic acid also react with the base. Let's take one example of base. Formula of ethanoic acid is, as you all know, it is CH3, C double bond O, OH. This is the ethanoic acid, general formula, also known as acetic acid. When it reacts with base, acid, base. When acid and base reacts, it results in the formation of salt and water. So what is the salt basically formed here? As you all know, acid releases the hydrogen ion. The hydrogen ion will be replaced from this acetic acid, and bases replace release OH minus ion. OH minus ion will be released from here. And rest, all of them, join them and write them. So the formula of next, the product is CH3COO and Na. Join them and write them. H2O is released. So this is the basically the salt formed in the reaction. And the formula of the salt, the name of the salt is, as we have told earlier, it is sodium ethanoid, or it can also be written as sodium acetate. So this is the basic reaction of ethanoic acid with sodium hydroxide or a base. Now let's see, we have already done the chapter number 3, that how the acid reacts with base. Similarly, how the acid reacts with metal carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonate. Do you remember the remember the products of that reaction? That how the acid reacts with metal carbonates or metal hydrogen carbonates? It result in the formation of salt, plus carbon dioxide gas is released, plus water is formed. Similar manner, similar type of reaction is given by the ethanoic acid. Similar reaction, no change at all. So the formula of the ethanoic acid is CH3, C double bond OH plus the acid with reacts with carbonates. Carbonate, for you can just the example of sodium carbonate. So Na2CO3, sodium carbonate. When it reacts with sodium carbonate or hydrogen carbonate, so you must know the formula of sodium hydrogen carbonate also. So initial reaction we basically करवा के देखेंगे. तो जब acid sodium carbonate और sodium hydrogen carbonate से react करता है, salt, carbon dioxide, water will form. So let's see what will form. We will see the reaction with sodium carbonate, Na2CO3. What are the products in this reaction? A salt is formed. H will be released from the acid. Acid will release the hydrogen ion. So this H will be released from this acetic acid, and rest all the compound can be written as CH3COONa. Again, the product is same like this reaction. It is sodium acetate plus carbon dioxide is released and water is released. The similar reaction is given with the metal hydrogen carbonate. बस यहाँ पर आपको metal hydrogen carbonate लिखना है. Product will be same. Okay. So this is how, these were the chemical properties of ethanoic acid. So we have seen what is ethanoic acid, what are its physical properties, and we have also seen what are the chemical properties, that is the chemical reactions of ethanoic acid. The next important carbon compound that we are discussing is the ethanol or alcohol. Now that we'll see ethanol. Basically, what is ethanol? Ethanol is a alcohol. Ethanol is a compound which contains alcohol as the functional group. In the alcohol, the attachment of OH group of atom is there in the ethanol. Simple formula अगर देखें इसका structure देखेंगे तो structure will be like this. CH3CH2OH, this is the basic structure, and this is the basic formula. A formula can be written like this also and this also. You just see how many carbons, 2 carbon, 3 to 5 hydrogen and OH. This is both the structures and both the formulas are correct. So let's see some physical properties of ethanol. Ethanol is liquid at room temperature, and generally it is known as alcohol, and it is a very active ingredient of all types of alcohol, wines, beers, etc. It is generally added in all types of alcohol. It is soluble in water in all the proportions. In it, all the proportion, it is soluble in water. Its use is quite injurious to health. It produces harm to the body. That's why alcohol consumption is injurious to health. Beside this also, it is widely used in the society. So, why the basic ingredient of the alcohol is ethanol. Dilute ethanol, consumption of dilute ethanol just causes the drunkenness in the body, but the consumption of pure ethanol, also known as absolute alcohol, that is very lethal and even cause the death of the person who is just consuming that pure ethanol, that is absolute alcohol. It is a good solvent. Ethanol is a good solvent. That's why it is also used. It is also used in the formation of various medicines like tincture of iodine, which is an antiseptic. Tincture of iodine में काम आता है. Cough syrups का formation हो. Tonics जो muscle building के लिए जाते हैं उनके लिए भी formation में this alcohol can be done. So let's see some chemical properties, that is the chemical reaction of ethanol. Chemical properties of ethanol में सबसे पहले हम reaction देखेंगे ethanol की with sodium, and then we will see the dehydration reaction. Only two reactions of ethanol is given in the book. So let's see how the ethanol reacts with the sodium. Ethanol having the formula C2H5OH. When it is reacted with sodium, so generally a simple type of displacement reaction takes place here. The sodium just replaces the hydrogen from air and forms a compound like this. It is C2H5ONA. Sodium यहाँ पे hydrogen जगह पे आ जाएगा. Sodium electropositive, oxygen electronegative, negative positive charges, and what is released here? A hydrogen atom is released, but hydrogen cannot be released in the atomic form. That's why hydrogen gas is released. You can just balance the reaction quite well. So this is the basic reaction of ethanol with the sodium. This is how it reacts. This compound which is formed in the reaction, name of the compound is important. Name of the compound is sodium ethoxide, and this is the release of hydrogen gas. Okay, now similarly, how the dehydration reaction is given by the ethanol, let's see. So dehydration reaction, what is the meaning of dehydration? Meaning of dehydration is the removal of water molecule. So let's see how the removal of water molecule can be done from ethanol. When C2H5OH, when C2H5OH, that is ethanol, is heated at 443 Kelvin, that is approximately 170 degrees Celsius. इतने temperature पर heat करना है in the presence of concentrated H2SO4. In the presence of concentrated H2SO4, it will result in the removal of water molecule from the ethanol. So how the water molecule is removed? This hydrogen, this oxygen, OH is removed, and one hydrogen from this. So what will the compound form? The compound form will be C2H4 plus H2O. Since H2O is released in the reaction, that's why this particular acid, concentrated sulfuric acid in this particular reaction, because it is just dehydrating the alcohol, it is known as dehydrating agent के नाम से भी इस reaction को हम देख सकते हैं, concentrated H2SO4. Now what is this basically? अगर इसको हम general formula देखें, आप hydrocarbon है, देखिए आप सुने, in this only carbon and hydrogen is present, it is hydrocarbon and match with the general formula of alkane, alkene and alkyne. You will see that this is the alkene of two carbon, that is it is ethene. So if you draw the structure of this, you will get the structure of the ethene like this. That means unformation of unsaturated hydrocarbon. So in this reaction, the ethanol is converted into the unsaturated hydrocarbon. This reaction is known as dehydration reaction. So these are the chemical properties of ethanol. Thank you.